What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. So another double eye swipe, and this is about a device that was pretty close to my heart. And the Nexus line of just devices was one of the greatest phone lines, tablet lines, whatever you want to call it. It was just such an incremental part of who I was as a person and my involvement with technology. And especially looking back at things now, I mean, if you've seen my double eye swipes on like the Nexus 4, the Nexus 5, the Nexus 6, all these different devices, they all have such a special place in my heart. And it's not even just me saying that. I mean, I reviewed so many devices in my lifetime. You guys can go back on the channel. Literally, I've probably reviewed more things than I needed to, but I can't stress enough how much the Nexus line means to me. And kind of going down that list of Nexus devices, the Nexus 7 was just the one device that I just needed to get out of the way, because it's just eating me on the inside that I still have not done one on this one yet in 2019. Now, I did one for this last year, and really the sad thing is, and the sad truth is, now much has changed since that initial review, because this thing is not getting software updates. This thing's not, you know, supported by Google really anymore. And also another sad aspect is, really, we haven't really seen a predecessor to this at the level that the Nexus 7 came in. I mean, we got the Nexus 9 and I reviewed that last year, but that's still really not at the level as the Nexus 7 was. And I still see this thing being brought up in so many different forums, whether that's on Reddit or whether that's even just in my DM sometimes. I see that the Nexus 7 is still brought up, and that just goes to show the legacy that this thing has. And I'm gonna try my best to not bash it too much, but there might be a case or here or there that I might say something negative, who knows. But of course I have to factor in the age and everything, and you know, this thing was released in 2013, so almost 6 years ago. That's pretty crazy. And kind of just looking around the body, the front, we have a 7-inch screen. It is LED, it's IPS panel, so that's super cool. The resolution was above 1080p, which is awesome. It was 1200 by 1920. The pixels per inch was 323. So not a completely like horrible panel. Again, this was back in 2013. So back then, I mean, panels were still pretty much for the most part 720p. I believe the Nexus 4 came out in 2013, 2012. That had a 720p screen. Eventually with the Nexus 5, that thing did go back up to 1080p. But so many devices even at this time still weren't up to par with the resolution of this device, which is awesome. And you also had a micro USB port, a headphone jack, and a front camera and a back camera, which is pretty much a big upgrade from the original Nexus 7, which I will hopefully get my hands on pretty soon. And the overall feeling in the hand when I was using this thing, I didn't feel like it was a completely cheap device. And again, I kind of see that with everything, but there are some cases where a device from 2013 would not necessarily feel the best. And I can even name some 2015, 2016 devices that don't feel that good. With this device, when you're holding it in the hands, I can definitely tell what people were talking about when they said this thing had that timeless appeal, this timeless design. The Nexus 7, without a doubt, when you're even just looking at it, it's so minimalistic. There's no branding on it. It's literally just a slab with just glass on the front, and it just looks so great, so minimal. And yes, there is a lot of bezel on it, but back then I'm sure Google wasn't necessarily thinking of, oh my god, we need to slim the bezels. They were just thinking about how we can just bring the most that we can for the specific price points and just kind of go from there and see what we can do. Now, that kind of covers up mostly about the hardware. There's no micro SD card slot. One cool interesting thing though is that right below the screen, there is a LED blinking notification, which is so cool. I don't necessarily see that in a lot of different tablets that are coming out anymore. Even a lot of phones, they still don't even have the LED blinking light because they're all bezel-less. They don't have that functionality anymore, but this device did have it, which is so cool. I guess there's some use to that bezel. Now, in terms of software, this is where things kind of get a little bit strange for the beginning with, but then it's actually a pretty huge advantage for owning a Nexus device, especially the Nexus 7. It started off with Android 4.3 Jelly Bean, which wasn't a horrible software at all. I think it was actually very, very good. But this thing was upgradable to Android 6.0 Marshmallow, and that's actually awesome. You know, I think that's great and everything. I think Android Marshmallow definitely brought a lot of features. It wasn't like as groundbreaking of as an achievement as Android Lollipop was, in my opinion, or even Android KitKat. And sidebar, it's pretty crazy that we had Android KitKat and Android Lollipop side by side next to each other in terms of update, because I think both those software updates were pretty big, but definitely Android Marshmallow was a decent ending point for the Nexus 7. But one interesting thing to note, and a huge advantage, like I said before, because this thing was a Nexus device, unlike bootloaders, you were able to just root this thing if you wanted to, and on top of that, you can custom ROM this device as well, and the amount of functionality you can achieve by just rooting and custom ROMing your tablet, it just breathes so much more life into it, and from the little bit of research I did, there's Android Marshmallow ROMs, obviously, there's Android Nougat ROMs, there's Android Oreo ROMs, and I think I did find some Android Pie ROMs as well, so there's still a little bit of development community behind this. I would really recommend you guys go on there, do your own research, go to XDA Developers, go to reddit.com/r/Nexus7 or whatever different Nexus 7 subreddits there are, or even Nexus subreddits. I would definitely recommend you to do your research there, man. This is some crazy stuff. Not every tablet back from 2013, 2014, or whatever, they don't have as big of a hype and a big of a following and development community as the Nexus 7 has. So for me to not even bring it up in a video would just be completely backwards. That's one of the biggest advantages for owning a Nexus, especially the Nexus 7. So that is amazing things right there. So that pretty much covers up pretty much a lot of stuff. Let's go ahead and talk about the performance. Now, this thing had the Qualcomm Snapdragon S4 Pro, a quad-core CPU, an Adreno 320 GPU, and 2 gigs of RAM. And what I'll tell you is, because this thing did stop at Android Marshmallow, the software was kind of optimized for these specific devices. They weren't necessarily made for devices with like 6 gigs of RAM and 10 gigs of RAM and 12 gigs or whatever. Android Marshmallow was, I think, a decent stopping point for this because of the specific hardware requirements that specific software needed. Now, what I will tell you is, it's not slow at all. I think it's definitely manageable. But for me to just tell you that it's perfect and everything would just be completely like bad on my part. What I'll tell you is this thing, for being a 2013 tablet, is surprising. It can definitely get you to point A to point B, but it is noticeably slow, okay? And that might be because of the S4 Pro chip. That might be because of the 2 gigs of RAM. I think it's mostly because of the 2 gigs of RAM. Multitasking is pretty limited. You can't really do, I wouldn't expect you to do too much out of it. But for being a 2013 tablet, like I said, it's surprising that this thing is still able to do what it is able to do. So for you running through the screens and opening apps and everything, I mean, I didn't notice it being extremely slow, but like I said, if you're going to go ahead and, you know, expect too much out of it, I would hate for me to recommend you this thing and being like, oh, it's perfectly fine and it's this, that. Obviously not. The newer tablets will be able to kind of help you out there, you know, but if you're doing decently not so heavy intensive stuff, you know, web browsing, watching videos, things like that, it's not going to, you know, be too much of a hassle for you to do it on a Nexus 7. But if you're expecting to do like super heavy intensive gaming and all these different things, you know, kind of expect different type of performance, and you can tell just depending on what you do, you will get different types of performance and levels from it. What I'll basically sum this and boil this down to is, it's not the best thing in the world anymore. When I factor in the age and everything, it definitely does go up in terms of just the raw powerfulness of it, because you're looking at it as a 6-year-old device and not like a 2019 device. But it's still not that good, and it's kind of a shame, but you know, that's kind of what happens with older technology, you know, things get obsolete over time. This thing by far is not obsolete, but it's also not something I would recommend people to get, if that makes any sense. Like, if you currently own it, that's fine, you know, mess with it, but I wouldn't recommend people to go out and necessarily buy it just based off the performance. So that's kind of where I would leave that at. I know it's kind of up in the air and it's kind of weird, but that's probably the best way I can go with like covering my tracks, really. So that's pretty much it about the performance. Now let's move on to the camera. I don't want to spend too much time talking about it, but it is a 5 megapixel sensor on the back. You can shoot 1080p videos on it, and I mean, it's not good at all, but you know, at least this thing did have it, which is surprising. I think even my Nexus 4, dude, I'll be honest, even my Nexus 5 devices, the cameras on those things weren't necessarily the best, which again is kind of a shame. I think the Nexus 7 was just kind of that in its infancy a little bit. I always mess up when I say that infancy, but I always say infancy or whatever. In terms of the front camera, we had a 1.2 megapixel sensor, and honestly, I think these things were basically just there for video calling and everything. With the first Nexus 7, the 2012 version, we only had a front-facing camera, which is basically made for video calls and everything, or selfies, but with this one, at least it has those capabilities, which is awesome. I wouldn't necessarily recommend anybody to use them anymore, but I really don't think anybody's planning on using them anyway, so that's pretty much how I would cover up those things. Now, this last thing I want to hit on is actually the battery life, and this is actually super interesting. So this thing has a 3950 milliamp hour battery, which is pretty big. Also keep in mind that this thing isn't really the hugest power consumption device ever. I mean, it's not extremely powerful. On top of that, the screen is, you know, only 7 inches. It's not like 12 or 13 inches what we have tablets nowadays. Not an extremely sharp display either. And this device, if you kept it on stock and if you kept it on a full battery, the 100%, no degradation, anything like that, this thing could last you obviously a very long time, not extremely long, probably not as long as like an iPad with a 44,000 mAh battery almost, but definitely it'll last you quite a bit of time. But the one thing to keep in mind, since 2013, the battery in this thing, in this device, has actually degraded by probably a lot. So it's probably like half this amount. It's not at that 4,000, it's probably like 2,000 at this point. And again, it just happens with every single device. So obviously, I would probably recommend you to keep a charger around you or whatever. If you happen to find one in really, really good condition, let me know. I would be interested in buying it. So what I'll say is, if this thing had a full battery, no degradation, obviously it lasts a while. But over time, being realistic, it probably won't last you that long, which is kind of a shame. This thing did have Qi wireless charging though, which is super surprising, and that is something that we didn't necessarily see in a lot of different tablets being released at this time. We still don't even see it in a lot of tablets being released now, so that is a pretty big thing that this tablet brought that tablet manufacturers are still really not even getting the memo about. So I pretty much covered up all the main points that I wanted to talk about, and to kind of sum this whole entire thing up, man, is the Nexus 7 worth it in 2019? What I'll definitely tell you is, if your needs are extremely, extremely basic, like I'm talking like you just need something to watch videos on or just kind of go on the internet every once in a while or whatever, then I guess it's not a bad thing at all. But if you even plan on doing anything more, if you plan on needing a device for a school or you need a device to do anything meaningful, like a paper you have to turn in or something, obviously I would not recommend getting this at all. You would pretty much be stepping backwards. You would probably be less productive getting this. And that's kind of all I'm going to bash it for. For everyone else though, if you're interested in getting to the custom ROM community, or you want to get into a development community, this device is a really cool stepping stone into that, because there's still a little bit of support behind this thing, you know, for the age that it is. I'm surprised people still even talk about it and the fact that it's still relevant. So for that, I mean, that's a really huge plus right there. If you own it, that's cool too. But I think most of you guys are watching this to kind of get a different viewpoint and to kind of get brushed up on the Nexus 7. You might have probably seen reviews about it many, many years ago, but just kind of interesting taking a look at these things and seeing how things have evolved and why these things are still relevant, and kind of seeing, man, this thing still has some features that devices in 2019 don't even have, which is crazy. If you want to pick up, I don't know, like a new Samsung Galaxy or new iPad, I'll link those in the description below. I can't link a Nexus 7 because they're not going to be on there anymore. Google, I think, makes their Google Pixel Books or Pixel C's or whatever. I'll try to get my hands on those as well and review them. But that is pretty much it. Let me know in the comment section below what you guys think about this. If you want to see specific devices reviewed, let me know in the comment section below. I'll try my best to get my hands on them. Hit that like button. That'll mean so much. But definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count. So it'll mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I would really appreciate if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. And hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out till then.